Welcome back. So we have defined, grouped and auto-filled our virtual signal. Next, we check for any new connections, run the diagnostics and then test the operation of our new virtual signal. So, step 4, connect. This is the last step in the switchboard, where we check for any new connections we may have made during our modifications. To do it, we just simply click the connect button. If any connections are listed here, select them all and press OK. There were no new connections in our case because the track layout has not changed. We simply replaced a bare piece of track with a piece of track with a signal attached. So no new connections to the track were made as far as iTrain is concerned. But you should always check as the last step before quitting the switchboard. So we can press OK to that, and now we can exit. But first, we should either press the Apply button, which will apply the changes to the active switchboard, but not save anything to the layout file. That is useful if you want to try the changes on the active switchboard before committing to saving the file. Or we can press Save, which will apply the changes to the switchboard and save everything to the current file. I'm happy to save, so I will do that and then click OK to exit. The final step, step 5, is diagnosis. In View, select Diagnosis, and immediately the diagnostics are run and any errors would be listed here. In this case, there are no errors, so we are good to go. We can just close it down. If there were any errors listed in that box, double click on each of them to see the error and correct it. Okay, good. So the virtual home signal is in place on the switchboard. And you will notice that the signal in the throttle is also now a British 3-aspect home signal and not the general type. Now, currently, there are no occupancy sensors fitted to any of the turnouts in this ladder. If I start the route, the path is reserved and the signal is showing a yellow aspect, meaning it is safe to proceed but to expect a stop at the next signal or the next block. We are in offline mode, so I need to progress the route manually by clicking on the next feedback in the route, which is this one in the destination block. As soon as the train enters the block, simulated by clicking on the feedback sensor, the signal immediately turns red. Because we have no feedbacks in any part of this ladder, we can't simulate the train entering this section. so we can't therefore simulate the state of the signal as the train leaves this block and crosses this section. So we next need to add occupancy sensing to the turnout ladder. And that is the subject of the next episode. So until then, bye for now.